Ever found yourself waking up feeling tired despite getting a full night's sleep? That's most probably because you didn't have enough fresh air in the room. Creating a healthy and comfortable indoor living environment begins with ventilating our spaces the right way. And without proper ventilation, we risk having stale air, mold growth, harmful pollutants, even allergens, and a diminished quality of life. But out of all the available types of ventilation systems, which one is the best for us and our buildings? That's exactly what we're going to explore. I'm Anton Dobrovsky, a past house trainer, and for the past 5 years, I've specialized in designing ventilation systems for energy-efficient buildings. So in this video, I will share my experience with you so that you can choose the right ventilation system for your project. When we speak of ventilation, we're referring to the process of moving air in and out of an interior space, replacing stale, potentially polluted air with fresh, oxygen-rich air from the outside. That's a seemingly easy process, but there are multiple ways to ventilate an indoor space and a couple of different types of ventilation systems to choose from. Ventilation systems are becoming more and more relevant topic in the building industry, especially in residential buildings. In old buildings, the ventilation is occurring naturally. The building is breathing through the cracks in the walls, doors, windows, while newer building codes are aiming to make buildings more energy efficient by making them more airtight, namely 10 to 20 times more airtight than existing buildings. However, in that way, we block the natural exchange of air. And this is why ventilation systems are becoming more and more important. But why is proper ventilation so crucial? Well, it has a direct impact on our health and comfort. Indoor air can be many times more polluted than outdoor air. And since we spend almost 90% of our time indoors, we want to make sure that the air is as clean as possible. Because the lack of fresh air can make you feel tired or even lead to headaches. And even worse is that the still polluted air can lead to allergies and multiple respiratory problems. Because whatever air pollutants are stuck circulating inside the building, you and your family are stuck breathing them. And to assure a healthy environment, the best is not to rely on remembering to open the window, but to have a ventilation system that will continuously be refreshing and filtering the air. Therefore, investing in proper ventilation is really investing in your family's health and well-being. So let's now look into the three main types of ventilation systems. Firstly, we have natural ventilation, which is simply uncontrolled ventilation that relies on natural forces like wind and the stack effect, where warmer air rises and cooler air settles, creating a flow of air through our spaces. Opening windows and doors is another example of natural ventilation. In older buildings, natural ventilation, as already mentioned, is the air that enters through unsealed spaces like cracks in the walls or floors. And historically, this was the most common ventilation method. And because most indoor spaces were leaky, drafty, and allowed for a certain amount of air in, additional mechanical ventilation was not needed. It's simple and doesn't require energy to operate. However, it has its limitations. Natural ventilation is subject to weather and climate conditions. On calm or extremely cold days, it might not provide sufficient air change. Plus, there's lack of control over airflow direction and speed, which could be a problem in polluted environments or in spaces where indoor activities produce pollutants. As mentioned previously, with the new building regulations, the more airtight a building is, the less effective natural ventilation is. And that's a big problem, especially with renovations, because when only insulation is added and the windows are changed, the building becomes more airtight, so there is less natural ventilation, therefore the interior humidity starts rising, which then leads to mold and even condensation. Furthermore, the air is not filtered. Basically, it's coming in from cracks and gaps in the building envelope, which are the exact places where mold grows, and these exact places you wouldn't even dare touch with a bare hand. But despite this, we're still breathing in this air that enters through these spaces. So I would say natural ventilation is a thing of the past. We can still use it occasionally, for example, for night cooling during the hot summer, but this should not be the main type of ventilation in your home. The second type of ventilation is exhaust ventilation systems, which, as the name suggests, focus on removing stale air from the building. They're often used to extract stale air from specific areas where pollutants or moisture may be generated, like bathrooms and kitchens, and in this way they improve the indoor air quality. So in this process, we're extracting the air, but we're not actively supplying air. This means the air is coming uncontrolled into the building, pulled in from the cracks and leaks and vents in the building envelope, just like with natural ventilation. But this means again that we have the same problem. This air could be coming in from spaces where there is mold or other pollutants and can result in worse air quality. Exhaust ventilation systems are even more harmful in warmer and humid climates because moisture is not removed from the air before it enters the home. So this increases the risk of moisture damage while increasing cooling costs and making these systems less energy efficient. And what happens in cold climates? Well, we're going to dry out the space and have too low humidity levels, leading to dry skin and respiratory problems. On top of that, we'll be dumping in cold air into the building, resulting in cold drafts and creating a really uncomfortable environment. Just imagine sitting on your couch and having cold drafts. No one wants to live in such a building. So overall, exhaust ventilation systems are simple and cost-effective to install, which is why they're often a common choice in many homes. However, because they can result in cold drafts, increased heating demand, leading to even worse air quality, I would not recommend them. Plus, very often these systems do not distribute fresh air evenly throughout the whole building. So if natural ventilation and exhaust ventilation systems are not an option, what system should we use? The system that combines all the benefits while fixing the issues of the previous two is called balanced ventilation system, and more specifically, heat recovery ventilation. Balanced systems effectively bring in fresh outdoor air and force out the stale polluted air from the inside. Therefore, depressurization and pressurization are not a concern with balanced ventilation systems because they efficiently provide and remove equal amounts of air. And in this way, they solve the issues of the previous ventilation systems that we discussed. So the balanced ventilation system filters the outdoor air so we don't bring in the pollutants and allergens from the outside, evenly distributes the fresh filtered air along the building, and then extracts it from the zones in which we have the most odors and moisture, like the kitchen and bathrooms. And to bring it a step further, we can minimize the heat losses, avoid the cold drafts, and maintain a healthy humidity levels indoors by using HRV or ERV systems. HRVs, or also called heat recovery ventilation systems, recover heat from the exhaust air and transfer it to the incoming air. ERVs on the other side, also called energy recovery ventilation, recover both heat and moisture. So they help maintain healthy humidity levels in very cold climates by keeping the higher moisture content inside, and also in warm climates where they keep the high moisture outside. And HRVs can recover around 90% of the heat. Or in other words, we reduce the heat losses through the ventilation system by 90%. And we're not going to have cold air dumping as well. So even though heat recovery ventilation systems are more expensive, due to all the saved energy, the return on the additional investment is very fast. And these systems can also be used in houses and apartments, in both new builds and renovations. But be aware that not all heat recovery ventilation systems work like this, because if the efficiency is very low, you're not going to get the desired results. So it's important to choose a high quality HRV unit with high heat recovery rates, and my advice would be to choose a Passive House Institute or PHI certified unit, because the certificate will guarantee that the unit will have a heat recovery rate of above 75% within the working range of the unit. And some people might say, oh, but I don't want to have a mechanical system. I want to open the windows, etc. Well, let's think about it. If you relied on opening the windows to ventilate a building, like with natural ventilation or extract ventilation, this means that even when outside it's too cold, you will still have to open the windows to bring in the fresh air, and this will also bring in all the cold from the outside. And you're gonna have to take a blanket because you're gonna get cold. You're gonna get uncomfortable as well, right? And not only that, but if you live in a busy city, you will also hear all the noise from the outside, which is definitely something you would want to avoid. But with heat recovery systems and ERVs, that's not the case, because these systems deliver fresh filtered air 24/7, and therefore you don't have to open the windows. But this does not mean that you're not allowed to open the windows. So with HRV and ERV systems, you can still open the windows, but you open them only when you want to do so. And your children could be running around the house barefoot without you being worried that they're gonna get cold. So if you aspire to live in a healthy, pleasant environment with fresh and allergen-free air, along with reduced energy costs, then heat recovery or energy recovery ventilation systems is the way to go. And properly ventilating a building is only one aspect of making a healthy living environment. Another crucial point for having good air quality inside is to avoid thermal bridges, which are invisible but very dangerous. So if you want to learn what they are and how to avoid them, check out this video. Thanks for watching, I hope you enjoyed it, and see ya next time.